So in that madke kaadu or the moth bean rasa, they add some jaggery, and that gives it that lovely earthy sweetness which contrasts quite nicely with that khara mixture and also that save, the thick save that you have on top. And all this is prepared in the eatery itself. So we're at Hubli's oldest restaurant, so opened by your grandfather. And there's also a grandfather clock there.
Yeah, it's a grandfather clock. That fan also is almost 60 years. Fridge is 50 years. 50 years.
That fridge is older than me. This place has so much character. The puri serves as a scoop to transport some of that patal bhaji. That's a nourishing breakfast. Well, we've set out to breakfast at what I'm told is one of Hubli's oldest restaurants. The only trouble is that we can't seem to find it. Well, I think we found it. And that I'm told is one of Hubli's oldest restaurants, if not the oldest. Namaskara. Are you Mr. Prakash? So you're the owner?
Fridge is 50 years.
50 years. That fridge is older than me. That fridge is older than me. It's a house.
We used to live here, but in 1965, we shifted to Deshpande Nagar.
Munche Maneli, Andre used to stay here and used to serve people here.
On top we used to stay. And we used to serve people. It was a Mane Antarla.
So earlier there were no tables and chairs, so there was Mane, basically low seating. So you would sit down one and you would have your food served on the other. And that's what it was all about.
And all slippers should be kept outside.
All slippers.
Wash their legs and hands, and then you used to come on top. So one son bachilittile adella iga
iga illa kala change agide reeti change agide janaru
andre hygienic maintain madaka
hygienic maintain madlike. So he says our focus on hygiene earlier was such that people couldn't walk in with their footwear, so there was a area there where they would remove their footwear and wash their feet and only then come in. This place has so much character. So Andre, as a child you must have run around in this courtyard.
I was born in 63. So from 65 we shifted this house from here to Deshpande Nagar.
So you know, like, not hi. What are you guys eating? Bread toast? What's special here?
Puri.
That's a misal, huh?
This is gol bhaji.
Gol bhaji.
This is aloo bonda. This is dry poha.
Dry poha.
Sukka poha they call, na?
So in it really tempering akidira. Haldi.
With garlic and shunti and chili.
Shunti chili.
Fry made. Then we mix with beaten rice poha.
I can smell the aroma of that
bonda.
Bonda, batate vada.
Batata vada means little small.
Little small. Bonda andre doddu.
Bonda andre doddu. Batata vada small. But same stuffing inside.
Same stuffing.
Stuffing.
Aloo gadde.
Yeah, aloo gadde.
And this is
with gol bhaji.
Gol bhaji. Onion.
Onion bhaji.
Idu nindu misal lige
mix. Ha, misal adda.
Khara mixture.
Khara mixture.
Same.
Ghati.
Ghati. Idenu besan ida?
Ha, besan ghati.
Idu new maduda?
Illa, ile maduda. Khara. Masala share kelsa.
Masala share.
Masala.
So all this is prepared here.
Yeah.
So olige in kitchen nodabodha
sir? Ha, nodabodha sir. Come.
Prakasha.
Ha, bande.
So the other hale kala na same
same yeah, maintain the same thing.
Fantastic. Look at the ceiling height here.
Ceiling height,
the
yeah.
Wooden rafters
wooden,
on top.
Full wood, all wood.
Mele enide?
Mele we had a house there. Now we made a storeroom.
So earlier
he used to climb here.
Mr. Bhatt's grandfather would come from
where? On top.
From the from upstairs. And he would then open his eatery.
Yes, yes, yes. Morning 5 o'clock he used to open the shop.
5 o'clock.
Customers would be there that time.
Huh.
But now the trend has changed. After coming this TV and mobile, all will get up at 8:30, 9 o'clock.
So you open only at 8 now?
Exactly 8:30.
8:30 you open. And you're open till
till 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
Till 2 o'clock
in the afternoon. So 1 hour lunch break is there, no lunch in the shop, no? So 1 hour lunch break. Then 3:30 we open with 4 items extra. Puva, vaggani, avlaki, mirchi, kirmet all we make. Shira evening.
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 That's the shira upit.
Yeah, shira upit.
Semolina, la, rava.
Rava, yes.
In tuppa vaidhe or in ne?
Tuppa.
Tuppa in the very nice. Idhen sambar, sir?
Haan, sambar.
ದೋಸೆಗೆ
ಇಡ್ಲಿ ಸಾಂಬಾರ್.
ಇಡ್ಲಿ ಸಾಂಬಾರ್
ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಐಟಮ್.
ಏನದು?
ಉಸಾಳ.
ಉಸಾಳ ಮಟ್ಕೆ ಉಸಾಳ.
ಮಟ್ಕೆ ಉಸಾಳ ವಿತ್ ಗ್ರೇವಿ.
ಸೊ ಇದು ಹೇಗೆ ತಿಂತಾರೆ?
ಇದು ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಈಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ವಿತ್ ಬ್ರೆಡ್ ಆರ್ ದಟ್ ಮಿಸಲ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಡೋ ನಾ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಬೇಸ್.
ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ಮಡ್ಕೆ ಉಸಾಳ.
ಮಡ್ಕೆ ಉಸಾಳ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ಪುಟ್ ಆಲ್ ದಟ್ ಖಾರ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿದ ಅವಲಕ್ಕಿ.
ಬ್ರೌನ್ ಕಲರ್ ಇದೆ ಆನಿಯನ್ ಇದೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ?
ನೋ ಆನಿಯನ್. ಲಸೂನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಚಿಲ್ಲಿ.
ಲಸೂನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಚಿಲ್ಲಿ.
ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಒರಿಜಿನಲ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಕಲರ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಡ್ರೈ ಕೋಬ್ರಾ. ಡ್ರೈ ಕೋಬ್ರಾ ಮಸಾಲೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕುರ್ಮಾ ಫಾರ್ ಪುರಿ. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆನಿಯನ್ ಪೊಟೇಟೋ ಗರಂ ಮಸಾಲ.
ಗರಂ ಮಸಾಲ. ಸೊ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಮಟ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಿಲ್ಲ?
No, you can add both if you want.
If you can add
that
both.
That gives us a different taste. Separate the, if they want to eat with puri bhaji. And bread also it tastes.
You can taste that. Okay. Chanage parimala bartha.
Yeah, yeah.
It is smelling so aromatic. Fantastic.
This is also on 70 years old.
ಇದು ಏನು? ಹಿತ್ತಾಳ.
ಹಿತ್ತಾಳ
ನೀರಿಗೆ.
ನೀರಿಗೆ ಹೌದು. ದಟ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಪುಟ್ ಕಡ್ಲಿ ಬೇಳೆ, ಉದ್ದಿನ ಬೇಳೆ ಆಲ್ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ರೂಮ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಫ್
ಗನಿ ಬ್ಯಾಗ್ಸ್.
ಗನಿ ಬ್ಯಾಗ್ಸ್ ಅವ್ರ ಕಬ್ಬಣದ ಬಾಕ್ಸ್ ಬದಲಿಗೆ
ಇದು
ಸ್ಟೋರೇಜ್. ದಿಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಒನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ ಆನ್ ಟಾಪ್. ಒನ್
ಕ್ಯಾಪ್. So these are brass containers that go back 70 years. So they would store the lentils.
Yeah, yeah.
And the various provisions
grains,
in this.
All grains.
All grains would be stored grains, in this.
Yeah.
With a lid on top.
Yeah.
ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ ತಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ.
ತಗೋರಿ
ಸೊ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಬೇಗ ಬೇಗ. ಸೊ ಆಸ್ ಯು ಟ್ರಾವೆಲ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಕನ್ನಡ ಬಟ್ ದ ಕನ್ನಡ ಚೇಂಜಸ್.
ಇಟ್ಸ್
ಆಲ್ ವೆರಿ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್.
ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ರೆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್
ಬಟ್ ದ ವೇ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೆಟ್. ತಗೋರಿ ಅದು for somebody who is not used to that.
Yeah,
I'll be wondering what is he threatening him about.
No.
But it's actually takoli ri takori.
Yeah, and you know the words are a little harsh, but people are very sweet.
like the water in this area, right? Yeah,
exactly.
So the water in this area is supposed to be sweet in this entire belt.
Yeah.
Hubli, Dharwad. Well, this eatery Suvarna Mandir is like a peek into the past, and a past that's at least about 80 years old, because this eatery I think for the most part seems to be like it was in the 40s or the 50s. So tell me, the food, has it changed over the years or the same kind of food?
Yeah, almost same.
Almost same food.
Almost same, yeah. And we used to only make some 3-4 items only. Now aloo bonda, bread butter, bread toast, masala dosa, all.
But puri bhaji was there earlier.
Ah, puri bhaji was there. But they used to eat puri usli.
Puri usli, ah.
That was here. They used to come for that only.
So now it's the puri bhaji, the patald bhaji.
With
the potato, and patald means thin.
Thin
gravy. So nange adu kodi. Amele ondu bonda.
Alu
bonda.
One misal.
One misal. Mate ond bajji sa kodi. Well, this is our last meal on this trip to Hubli, and to be honest, we almost didn't make it here because it's been raining the last few days, and it also seemed like it was threatening to rain, but thankfully it didn't, and somehow we found our way to Suvarna Mandir here in Durgadbail, and we've got that dish, the dish that I'm told is very popular here. This is the misal. So there's some poha on top, there's a madke kalu, the gravy at the bottom, then you've got some masala khara, you've got some poha, you've got some sev, this is topped with the bhaji, so that comes as a lovely bonus. So anyway, let's get to the misal. So in that madke kalu or the moth bean rasa, they add some jaggery, and that gives it that lovely earthy sweetness which contrasts quite nicely with that khara mixture and also that save, the thick save that you have on top. And all this is prepared in the eatery itself. And that poha basically helps provide a bit of the dry crunch. That's delicious. Some toasted curry leaf there along with the poha. I can taste the flavor of that curry leaf now. This dish is all about flavors and textures. So you got some spice as well. I think there's some badgi mentsin kai powder that goes into that while they're making the madke kalu. And then of course the sweetness that comes from the jaggery. And then the spice that also comes from that khara mixture. And in terms of textures, you got the soft bite of the madke kalu, contrasting with the crispy crunch of the mixture, the sev and the poha. And as a bonus, you also get some bhajji, niruli bhajji. And this one has some chili right there. It's not hot, but it's more about the flavor. I can definitely taste the khara of that green chili. I think that bhajji provides a bit of a flavor boost as you're tasting that misal.
Puri bhajji.
Ah.
Alu bonda. Madki kal.
Ah, this is a madki kal. I'm not ready to let go of my misal yet, but the other dishes I've made it to our table, that puri. This is a comforting bite. And to perk things up, that onion bhajji. You got the fried onions on the outside and you got the soft pulpy onions inside, which are also slightly sweet. And then the spice of the green chilli. Doesn't take much to make one happy. Simple food, cooked with love, cooked with care. That's all that you need. And now we have a puri bhajji here. Three puris with the chutney and this is the telu bhaji. I can definitely taste the aromatic flavors of that garam masala. That garam masala has probably gone into the ogurne. I can also taste a bit of that oil, that aromatic oil coating my lips. Let's go for that puri. Of course, the puri has deflated a bit, lost some of its steamy vigor while I was enjoying that misal. But I'm sure the flavors will still pretty much be there. Because after all, the puri serves as a scoop to transport some of that patal bhaji. This is definitely about that patal bhaji. I love that. Here, what I see here, there's a bit of sweetness in the madke kalu that I tasted and also in this patal bhaji. But what is apparent here is the flavor of the spices, huh? Isn't it chakke lavanga like them? Cloves, the cinnamon.
Sajira. Jira.
ಎಣ್ಣೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಒಗ್ಗರಣೆ ಕೊಡ್ತೀರಾ?
ಎಣ್ಣೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಒಗ್ಗರಣೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟ
ಮಸಾಲಾ ರೆಡಿ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ. ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟೇಸ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ಅರೋಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕ್ ಆಯಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಟು ಮೈ ಲಿಪ್ಸ್. ವಾಸ್ ಡಿಲಿಷಿಯಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಔಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದಿ ಜಾಗರಿ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಬೋತ್ ದ ಡಿಶಸ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಟೇಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಅಪ್ ಅಂಟಿಲ್ ನೌ, ವೆದರ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪಾತಾಳ್ ಬಾಜಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದಿ ಮಡಕೆ ಕಾಳು. ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ರೇಸ್ ದ ಚಟ್ನಿ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಸಮ್ ಕೋಕೋನಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ಲಿ ದ ಕಡಲೆ ಬೇಳೆ. ಇದೇನು ಪುಟಾಣಿ ಚಟ್ನಿಯಾ? So I think the putani and that kai, coconut is, I'm told, goes in equal measures. But the coconut is ground very finely. And I think there's definitely some green chili that I'm tasting in that. With that ogarne of the sasve. Hunsena haakta illa?
No, illa, hunsena.
So andre, patal sabzi alli sulpa sweetness ide, patal bhaji alli, idralli sulpa khara irbeku. So that khara or that green chili in that chutney balances against the sweetness of that patal bhaji. I think what we're going to do next is go for a generous scoop of that patal bhaji and also get some of the chutney onto it. This puri is also quite thick. So I think if you have three of them, and perhaps with an order of the misal, I think that will keep you happily satisfied at least for a couple of hours. I think next, let's taste some of that. This is the madke kalu. So this is a long process. So they have to soak it, then they have to sprout it, and then they cook it. I'm told there's some ginger, some garlic. Dry coconut, amele bella. I think there's also some red chili powder in that. That's a nourishing breakfast. You got a bit of the pungency of the garlic that you're tasting, in addition to the warmth of the badgi mentsin kai powder, the chili powder. You can dunk your puri into this, but I think this also makes for a nutritious bowl along with whatever you're eating for breakfast here. So I think if you are eating the misal and you want to taste something nutritious and tasty, I think definitely ask for a bowl, a katori of that madke kalu. Just to cleanse my palate of some of the sweetness before I taste the bonda. So this bonda, I am told by Mr. Bhatt, is large as compared to a batata vada, and that's what makes it a bonda. So the bonda is not hot anymore, it's been fried and kept in the showcase there. There's plenty of turmeric in the potatoes there, and also the casing is somewhat thick. So I think the casing here is not just about enclosing the potato stuffing, but it also is bready in its texture, so it gives some heft to every bite. Plenty of coriander in the potatoes. The casing of that bonda is almost crunchy. There's a lovely aroma and flavor of the asafoetida that I'm tasting in that. So he says they do an ogurne. So I think once they make the potato sabzi,
having asafoetida, that digestion will be easy.
Digestion will be easy. No side effects.
No side
effect. So the food that is cooked here is cooked to age-old principles. Andre lentils idre, potatoes idre, athwa bele idre. Sometimes you may have the unpleasant side effects. So, adke asafoetida hakana. That will help mitigate that. And that's the kind of cooking that you will see in all the dishes out here at Suvarna Mandir. Itke Suvarna Mandir yake hai saru?
Grandfather,
an eatery that's called a temple. You are certain that they definitely pay a lot of attention to the food. It chutney ni chanage karade. And some sambar if you want. The nice flavor of the bele in this and the sambar masala. So there's also some potatoes that have gone in. So the potatoes help you get a bit of a bite, a bit of that mushy bite, and also helps slightly thicken that sambar. Go for that aloo bonda with the chutney. The casing of that vade is almost biscuity in its texture, like a soft biscuit. But what you taste mostly is a punch of the coriander, is a fresh coriander, the sasve, the mustard seeds, and that hingu. That hingu is what gives it flavor. That's because at the end, they add some hingu to ogurne, some tempering that has hingu or asafoetida in it, and that's what gives that bonda its principal flavor. Is there a chai there, coffee there?
Chai, coffee, kashaya.
Kashaya, chai there?
Milk, kashaya powder.
This is the old menu.
Old menu. Around about 70s in the 70s.
Moth paise ke ne to?
Moth paise. Ido puri bhaji single, double. This is 20-30.
So yeah. Single puri bhajis with two puris was 20 paise.
Yeah.
If you add the full, which had three puris, was 30 paise.
Yeah.
This was when 70s.
Almost 70s. Coffee was 15 paisa. Puri was 8 paisa. The cha was 8 paisa.
Well, that was the pricing in the good old days. So the food is still the same, the pricing of course has changed.
Almost changed.
Lovely to see that you've preserved this.
One I have preserved. This board was there first time.
Oh, they would get confused.
Yeah, confused. Now we don't eat this.
So munche board horege ittu. So people would come, they would get confused and say, okay, fantastic. Let's order everything on the menu. So therefore he took it, kept it aside.
Steel start adaga 1967 daga.
ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಜಗ್ ನಿಮಗೆ ಬಂತು
ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಜಗ್
ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಜಗ್
ಅಲ್ಯೂಮಿನಿಯಂ ವೆಸಲ್ಸ್ ಹಿತ್ತಾಳಿ ವೆಸಲ್ಸ್ ಇದ್ದು ಸ್ಟೀಲ್ ಬಂದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಈ ಜಗ್ ನೋಡಿ
ದಿಸ್ ಜಗ್ ಈವನ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಡೇಟ್ ದಟ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಟು 1967 ಸೊ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಔಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಲಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಅಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಆನ್ ಪ್ರಿಸರ್ವಿಂಗ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ 50 ಇಯರ್ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಫ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ 50 ಇಯರ್ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಮೆನ್ಯು
ದಟ್ ಫ್ಯಾನ್ 60 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಓಲ್ಡ್
So is it difficult to preserve things as opposed to just buy something new?
No, it is such a good quality that nothing happens. Nothing would happen at that time.
Nothing would happen.
Yeah, and
it's still used.
Yeah, it is still in use.
What do you put in that now?
Now we keep cold drinks.
Cold drinks, okay.
Coca-Cola. And,
fantastic. Yeah. So I think this is probably the oldest fridge in the country which is storing aerated drinks. There's a Bekku also. Bekku andre. New Bekku, adu 50 varsha irlekilla. I said everything here is 50 years. I was wondering even if the cat is 50 years old.
Kashaya,
fantastic, sir. So after this indulgent breakfast, actually I'm not done with my breakfast yet. I thought I would redeem myself by ordering some kashaya. I'm busy there, tatte busy there. I can smell the coriander jeerige in this, and the sweetness of the fennel. Oh, that's delicious actually. You know, I thought when you sin a lot in terms of excesses in food, you want to offer penance. And I thought this kashayam would be that for me. So I said I will drink it, even though it may not taste the best. But I must tell you, this kashayam too is a sort that probably your grandmother would make for you. And I think that's a fitting end to our meal here at Suvarna Mandir, one of Hubli's oldest, if not the oldest eatery still standing. This is an establishment that began in the 40s, and the third generation of the family, Mr. Bhatt, is still proudly carrying forward the legacy of his grandfather. This is a house that's converted into an eatery. The family used to live upstairs, and perhaps Mr. Bhatt as a kid has played in the compound of the house, which is where they serve customers. I think experiences like these are rare, if not impossible to come by. So if you want to peek into a tasty slice of history that goes back over 70 years, make it a point to stop at Suvarna Mandir when you are here in Hubli.
Erad puri bhaji, erad misal, ondo bonda, mate kashayam, mate adu badke kaalu.
Madke kaalu, right.
Eshtu aitu sir?
ಇದು ಮತ್ತೆ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇಕಾಯ್ತು
ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ ನಂದ್ರ ಪಾಲಿಸಿ ಸರ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಳೇಬೇಕು.
ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ಎಂಜಾಯ್ಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಪಿಸೋಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಗೋರ್ಮೆ ಆನ್ ದ ರೋಡ್. ಅಂಟಿಲ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮ್, ಟೇಕ್ ಕೇರ್, ಸ್ಟೇ ಸೇಫ್, ಸ್ಟೇ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಕಷಾಯಂ ಆಫ್ ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪಿ ಡ್ರಿಂಕಿಂಗ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ವುಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಟು ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ದ ವರ್ಕ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಡೂ ಅಟ್ ಫುಡ್ ಲವರ್ಸ್ ಟಿವಿ, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the homepage. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share and leave a comment below. Happy eating!